An average human being can read at a speed of about 200 to 300 words per minute. But this man, Howard Stephenberg, has a Guinness World Record of reading at about 25,000 words per minute. Can you imagine? It's crazy. Now, what if there is a technique by which you too can increase your reading speed, not to 25,000 words per minute, but at least 500 to 600 words per minute? What would be the benefits? You can read more, you can utilize your time, and you can learn faster. Trust me, there are a lot of techniques out there of speed reading by which you can read at a faster rate. In the 21st century, the one skill that will help you to grow faster, to get that awesome job, to be in the best schools, to work with world leaders, the ability to learn faster. And not just literature reading. Imagine you are able to skim off information from contracts, from emails, from newspapers. Wouldn't that be great? You are able to skim a lot of information in less amount of time. Hey guys, welcome to this new video. In this video, we are going to discuss some speed reading techniques. There are a lot of techniques out there. I'm personally discussing those techniques which I found easier to incorporate into my reading schedule. And this technique is very simple. Stay with me till the end, watch the video till the end. You may never know which point or which fact may resonate with you and change the course of your life. So let's get started.
The world's fastest reader, Howard Berg, is wrapping up. That's right, he appears to be wrapping up, much like Ali in that 15-round extravaganza.
Let's rewind back to the school days when we had just started reading. Whenever the teacher used to say A for, the whole class used to scream apple. Whenever teacher used to say B for, the whole class used to scream ball. This is the way we were taught reading.
And that's for the most of us, the first and only time we have ever done a reading class.
This is known as sub-vocalization. Whenever you are reading something, there's an inner sound which comes in your mind. For example, I'll show some text on screen right now. When you're reading that text, notice that inner sound which is coming when you're reading it. Did you notice it? The science behind it is now, your eyes have the capacity to read faster, your brain has the capacity to read faster, but they both slow down to match that inner voice. Your brain slows down, your eyes slows down. That is why we read so slowly. Plus, when the brain is slowing down its speed, it tends to get distracted. Most of us are still reading like kids. There has to be a different technique for adults. As adults, we are required to consume a lot more information, consume more complex information in less amount of time. Like I said before, the act of consuming a lot of information is very essential in today's times. And using this very simple technique, you can increase your reading speed from about 200 to 300 words per minute to about 500 to 600 words per minute. I myself have started using this technique since 3 months and I can see my growth. And plus, while reading, I'm much more focused than on what I'm reading. How to break this habit of slow reading and switch to a more effective technique in which you are focused while reading and also you are able to consume a lot more, you are able to read a lot more. It's very simple. All you need is a guide, a pointer. It can be anything. For the first few days while you are reading, you have to employ this method. So when you are reading, hover your pointer around the words at a speed which is greater than the speed of your sound. Hover it around while you are reading. And just continue this for around a week. It may sound difficult at the beginning. It may feel that you're not understanding anything. But trust me, it takes time to build this habit. But once you have built it, there's no stopping you. What happens in this technique is, when you're hovering around, your eyes have to match the speed of this pointer. And your brain also has to match this speed. So there's no time for that inner voice to distract you. Whenever your pen is hovering around, you'll always be focused on those words. And your brain would be continuously processing those words. This helps a lot in increasing your speed. Plus, when you are reading, you are totally focused on reading only. You are able to consume more and you are able to retain more. The best part about this method is that once you have increased your speed, once you have decided this is the maximum speed at which I can read, you can also slow it down. Because I feel there are some books where you need that slow reading, you need that leisure time and, you know, soak in all the emotions. So for that, you can again decrease your speed. But I feel most of the times we all are in a hurry. We have less time. We have a lot of things on our plate. So active reading is the thing to go. This practice is also known as active reading, in which you are focused on the words also. Other than faster reading, you're focused on the words also. You know which paragraph is of importance and which paragraph is not of importance. You may increase your speed in the paragraphs where you don't think it's important. So it works that way. Before starting with this technique, you can first know your actual speed. you know, count the words per minute, count the number of words that you are able to read, and then try to set benchmarks and then try to increase it slowly. It may take baby steps, but trust me, once you have gathered that confidence of reading, speed reading, you can finish books in like seconds, not seconds, minutes. So when you research about the speed reading techniques, there are a lot of books on this topic. There's a heated debate whether this technique is effective or not. I'll try to deconstruct those ideologies as well. So the first question which people ask are, doesn't the emotional experience of reading the book count? When you're reading, you're not actually, you know, getting attached with the book. No, you are getting attached, and sometimes that's the beauty of it. You can increase and decrease your speed as and when required. People ask whether it's more tiring than leisure reading, because now you are more focused and now you don't have really have the time to think around and stuff like that. But when you're leisurely reading, it's not much of an activity for you. But let me tell you, it's like a brain exercise also. Just like your muscles need exercise and then they get flexed, you need exercises for your brain as well. So why not use it by reading? The most frequently asked question about this is whether you are able to retain the information because you're reading everything so quickly. Yes, your brain has that power to retain that information better than what you were actually doing. When you were also phonetically saying it in your mind, it was actually slowing down everything and slowing down your retention capacity as well. So if you want to practice the art of active reading, you always have to read in this way. Once you're comfortable with the technique, you can remove the pointer and your eyes just can hover around really quickly. This is the technique used by many of the speed readers around the world. People have completed the Harry Potter and the Cursed Child book in about 47 minutes, if I'm not wrong. So this is all due to speed reading. For example, try reading this sentence. Could you catch up? If you were able to catch up, congratulations, you've just started practicing speed reading. So that's all for this video, guys. I hope you found value in this video. If you liked my content, don't forget to share this video, to subscribe to my channel. I'll be putting more such content. And thank you so much for supporting me. I've been getting some really supportive messages and emails. I'm really thankful to you guys. Stay tuned and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.